Welcome to the Spy Collection. This is Anastasios, and in this episode we will have a look at an ancient Greek device used for secure military communications, the Aeneas disk. First of all, just to clarify, this is a reproduction since there is no original Aeneas disk anywhere in the world. This is an identical reproduction to that found in the Technology Museum of Thessaloniki in Greece, but we'll have a look at another reproduction we have in the Spy Collection too later in this video. To start with, who was Aeneas Tacticus? He was a military writer from the 4th century BC that was known in Greece as Aeneas Tacticus, which literally translates to Tactical Aeneas. Aeneas was his name. In today's world, we could compare Aeneas Tacticus to a military analyst. He was studying conflicts, tactics, techniques and procedures of different military units and was documenting them. For example, some of his work includes the Surviving Under Siege, On Strategic Memoranda, Tactical Field Manual and others. According to some historians, he was considered the earliest Greek writer on the art of war and is referenced in the Encyclopedia of Cryptography as the first author of secure military communications. This device that we have here was described in his work on secret messages, and it does not reference where exactly did Aeneas saw this device being used, but he mentions that it was a quickly constructed device for communicating secret messages between military officials in Greece. The most widely adopted representation of the device is this one. In reality, that disk was made out of a piece of wood and a string. The two parties that wanted to exchange a secret message would agree on a secret key. That was a single letter. Let's say it was letter B, as in Bravo. Then this means that the center hole represents the letter B and the outer ones the rest of the letters, starting from the one in the center. For this reason, in Greek, we'd have 24 holes, while in the Latin alphabet, we will have 26. The sender would then thread the string, starting from the sender through each of the letters of the message, having this alphabet in mind. If the letter appeared more than once, they'd first route the string through the other inner hole. For example, to encrypt the word good, with the key being B, as in Bravo, we do the following. The disk was then given to a courier who could easily destroy the wooden disk by breaking it or cutting the thread in case they got captured. But even if they didn't, it would be hard for someone to find out what this strange device was used for. Now, once the recipient got it, they knew the secret key, B in this case. So they would use that to write the message in reverse order by unthreading the string. In our example, we have B, C, D. So D, we write that down. When we have O over here, and we have another O, so, and the last letter is W, and then we're back to the sender. So the word is wood. Now, before we jump to the realistic reproduction, let's understand the cryptography behind this system. This is a so-called substitution cipher, since it replaces a letter for another, and it's doing that by shifting the alphabet to start from a different letter. Also, it always replaces the same letter with the same ciphertext. Thus, it uses a single replacement alphabet. That makes it a monoalphabetic shift substitution cipher. There are 26 for the Latin alphabet or 24 for the Greek one, potential secret keys for encryption and decryption. And we use the same secret key for both the encryption and decryption process. So, it's symmetric cryptography, the same key used for both operations. This means our cryptographic classification is a symmetric cryptography monoalphabetic shift substitution cipher. Mathematically speaking, it's an extremely simple system based on the finite set of 26 or 24 holes. So to encrypt, letter X, we have to replace this letter based on the offset of our secret key. Let's call it K. However, because we have a finite set of letters, either 26 or 24, we have to make sure we use modular arithmetic to stay within those boundaries. Thus, it could be mod 24 or 26, depending on the alphabet. The decryption process is exactly the same, but in reverse order, meaning a subtraction. Alright, now that this is clear, let's move to a more realistic version. What you see now is a more realistic representation of this cipher disk. This one has 26 outer holes, thus it's for the Latin alphabet, and you can see that it has many more holes inside. That's because in the original text by Aeneas Tacticus, it said that multiple holes could be drilled in the inner part to confuse the enemy, but their use was exactly as described before. The only difference is that you could use them to make the disk appear more confusing. However, the only parts that matter were the pre-agreed secret key, the starting letter in the center holes, and the outer ones. Now, if you are curious, assuming that the secret key is C, as in Charlie, can you decipher this message? Of course, breaking this cipher system would be pretty simple. Even trying all the potential keys is just 24 or 26 combinations. However, there is no documented case of any attempts for cryptanalysis of the Aeneas disk. This doesn't mean it didn't happen, just that it wasn't discovered by any historian or archaeologist yet. In this episode, we saw an over 2000 years old system used by military officials to exchange messages that even when intercepted would be hard to understand. It was combining some basic mathematics with secrecy and deception to allow battlefield commands and intelligence to flow securely, a great example of ancient tradecraft and how far back the motto of our channel gets us. Nothing is as it seems.